gonna show 'em where it's at.
The haters. Haters are gonna hate inevitably.
Who is it? Cat Williams says if you don't have any haters, you're not doing something right.
All six of them, you worked your tail off.
5 seconds left.
Four, you dream it.
Three, what do you
think? That was three. Two questions, 2 weeks.
One.
For the game we love, there sure are all kinds of hate going around.
I hate holy jeans.
I hate sitting on the bench.
I hate that rule. I hate how he's backwards on the screen.
But when it comes to their opponents, that's when the real haters come out.
There's also kind of a bloodlust in the stadium that day.
Eagles suck! Eagles suck!
Hey, they hate us! They hate us! We hate them too!
We ripped the horse out of these haters!
You ain't nothing but dumb, Eli! Put three letters in your name!
I mean, if you hate a team, you have to pick a guy to hate. You have to have a guy to personify that team.
We love being a bad guy.
In our countdown, we take a look at those players who take the heat by being hated.
Take that!
I think there's two levels of people we hate. We hate people that are really, really good because they usually beat our team.
Well, I don't like that. I hate that.
Then there's the other kind of hate. When the guy is just an awful human being, so you hate him for who he really is.
I hate the world.
In the yin-yang world of the NFL, these are the players you love to hate.
That's why I hate you and love you at the same time.
The number 10 player you love to hate. Warren Sapp.
Number 10? You've got to be kidding me. Who's on there, Attila the Hun?
He absolutely deserves to be on the list. He should be number one.
He's not a guy that I love to hate, but I can kind of see how he can get on people's nerves and get under their skin.
That's how it works. They use the hate to motivate.
Eminently despicable, isn't he? I mean, that's a guy who will absolutely mug for the cameras and then go out on the field and be your worst nightmare.
He's dead beat. Warren Sapp got him at the 30-yard line.
If he wakes up on a day and he is not hated by someone, he can't go on.
I said, I think I was pissed off a long time before I got here. Is there something wrong with your ears?
You know, I think Warren relished the role of being the villain.
Hit me up, QBKiller.com.
The greatest villains in football history are also the guys who talk the best game. Warren Sapp was that guy who'd funnier than you.
Oh, stand up the gut!
He's quicker than you.
He's about as dumb as a box of rocks.
He delivers a better line than you.
If you make it past 24 with a silver spoon in your mouth, because most of y'all kill yourself, you know that.
Absolutely hateable.
He make me look like his bitch.
Warren Sapp's idea of warming up before a game was to do a dance in your warm-up.
He was like, you know the Mummers Parade? They go like this. He's like Superman. He's like a plane. He would run through on purpose, and it annoyed the crapola out of them.
I wish he would have walked through our drill.
Sapp hit our charts by busting a moon.
It was just this overt cockiness that just came out at number 99.
Are you kidding me?
The Beyonce dance in the end zone after he catches a touchdown.
How many big people are going to see that dance around like that? He's a jolly fellow, man. That guy can dance. He's Twinkle Toes.
So Twinkle Toes, tell me.
Could you live with someone who's just mean and just evil? Or someone who's laughing every time he tackles you? With those bright eyes and that big smile. I don't know what's more irritating.
Well, number one, on top of the reasons that people don't like Warren Sapp, that the hit against Chad Clifton was a cheap shot.
And he lays out Clifton. Boy, he launched himself on that one.
And then later, when Mike Sherman stands up to him on the field, he tells Sherman to put a jersey on.
Put a jersey on! Put a jersey on! He's on top, put a jersey on!
The whole Sapp episode is just, you absolutely should be on this list, if not number one.
He didn't care if he was hated. In fact, he relished it.
Coming up, can you hate a player?
Please don't hate me!
With without actually hating the player?
Showtime primetime.
There was really no substance to what exactly are we hating.
He hasn't done anything wrong. It's the coverage that has been wrong.
Let's go. Come out swinging. Let's go.
Pro football is a game where the fight for supremacy is sometimes taken literally. Anyone can get caught up.
I'll fight you!
And some guys even make a habit of it.
Cortland Finnegan is as close to an NHL player as the NFL has.
Finnegan is one of those guys who you absolutely love to hate. I can't believe he's best of the rest of them.
31.
Believe me, I watch him every play everywhere.
Andre Johnson, who's one of the easiest going guys, just unleashes. That shows you how good Cortland Finnegan is at getting under someone's skin. He embraces that villain mentality.
But it's not just villains that we love to hate.
Hey, you got one more time, fuck boy.
The number nine player you love to hate, Tim Tebow.
Tim Tebow. I love Tim Tebow. People hate Tebow?
Yes.
And you know what? He is going to thank God, his God, that he's on this list.
Thank you, Lord.
It's really strange. I mean, to say you hate Tim Tebow, it's like saying you hate ice cream.
Well, what's there to hate about this guy?
All right, I'll look forward to seeing you after the game. All right, buddy?
I should love the guy. Why don't I love the guy?
Why do I love to... How long are we going to be here? Why do I love to hate Tim Tebow?
He's so genuine that he's disingenuous.
If you can't control it, don't worry about it.
It's like, here's reality, here's his niceness floating around out here.
All right, y'all have a blessed day.
I hate him for the area in between those two things. The distance between reality and where his niceness lives is like the distance between where his arm, where his release point is and where it should be. That's right.
It bothers football purists that this guy gets any respect when he looks so disgusting throwing the football sometimes.
The number nine player you love to hate earns angst aplenty for his passing mechanics.
Oh boy, gets underneath it.
Or lack thereof.
And the ball just floated wildly behind him.
You can be the nicest guy in the world. If you can't play, you can't play.
For all his faults as far as mechanics, he has a winning record as a quarterback. And as a quarterback, don't we all want to have a quarterback that wins more than he loses? He took a team that was 1-4 in Denver and put him in the playoffs.
Are you kidding? Tim Tebow!
It's just another one of those rumors.
Nobody hates Tim Tebow. He's a good kid.
Thank you, Tim Tebow.
You hate the attention that Tim Tebow brings.
They hate Tim Tebow because we talk about him so much, because we're doing this again on Tim Tebow.
We're in New York City, and it's the middle of March, and there's a press conference to welcome the backup quarterback, and there's 200 credentialed media members.
How's it going? Good to see all of y'all.
That is hateable.
A lot of people here.
I'll never forget the back page of the New York Post. And they had Tim Tebow running shirtless in the rain. If there was anybody left that liked Tim Tebow, once they saw that, they went the other way.
But I'll say this about Tim Tebow. I've met a lot of men in my day. He by far is the single most handsome human being I've ever met in my life. We're all trying to figure out, why is it that a guy that clearly can't play quarterback at the NFL level...
intercepted at the 35-yard line.
I'll let them throw it.
Is a quarterback at the NFL level.
I don't get how he could possibly make the list, because who cares? I don't think he's relevant enough to belong on the list.
And guess who was on special teams?
If this guy gets another opportunity.
Hey, get set. We're winning the game right here.
Let's go, baby.
Trust me. Let's go.
That would be the biggest miracle of his career.
The number eight player you love to hate, Ndamukong Suh.
He could be the dirtiest player that I remember in the NFL.
Ndamukong Suh, oh boy, gets kicked. There's just no place for that in football.
He's filthy. He's just a filthy, filthy player.
Suh took him down hard on the play.
I don't know if he's the dirtiest player, but if he's not, he's certainly trying.
Sue went down on the shoulder.
Ndamukong Suh just plays the game a little too rough for everybody else.
He's the dirtiest player in the league. I think Lions fans love the fact that he's the dirtiest player in the league. I mean, he's put together a highlight reel of some of the dirtiest plays in football.
Suh is kicked out of the game.
And he's only been active for 3 years.
Despite all pro recognition, Ndamukong Suh remains defined by reputation.
All you got to do is ask Jay Cutler. I mean, he's had some sacks on Jay Cutler that were clean, that were by the book legal.
Being chased by Suh. Sue's got him and he's going to go down.
And I think Jay Cutler's hurt. Suh grabbed him by the shoulder pads and then went down on the shoulder. But that's a clean sack.
That's a clean sack.
But he made it look dirty.
Ndamukong Suh takes it to a street level that people say, oh, whoa, wait a minute. He's being too rough out there.
He's had some questionable plays in some really big games that everybody was watching.
Oh, boy, it wasn't just any kick.
He jams his helmet into the turf to start with about three times, and then at the end of this is when he makes the kick. There's just no place for that in football.
Okay, maybe he went over the line a little bit there, but so what?
A little stomp here and there, anything goes in that in the trenches. I mean, you get guys holding on to body parts that shouldn't be held on to.
What?
Number 90 is disqualified.
He's got some, like, deep-seated anger issues.
And Ndamukong Suh is just playing the game the way it's supposed to be played.
Everything that he has done that is dirty, it's not dirty in the sense that they haven't been done before. It's just dirty in the fact that he got caught.
So we wonder, is our number 8 player you love to hate just a victim of his era?
Nobody would have said a word if he was playing in the 60s or 70s or maybe even 80s.
I try to put him in the hospital every time I tackle him. I wanted to put as much fear into his heart and as much pain on his back as I possibly could.
If you sat down with Dick Butkus or some of those guys from that era and showed them some of the things that Ndamukong Suh has been vilified for.
Ndamukong Suh's got him and throws him down.
They'd say, we did that on a weekly basis. Are you kidding me? That?
Fair or not, for Suh, perception now trumps performance.
The fact that he's a really good football player and an impactful football player has been lost somewhere along the way.
Ndamukong Suh wrapped him up and you're not getting away from him.
This is somebody who has a rage inside of him that makes him a great player. And unfortunately, sometimes that rage goes right into his foot, which goes onto your chest, and you just have to live with it.
Up next, whose most memorable moments are his biggest blunders?
I mean, this is a guy that every time any of the chips are down can never come through.
This is a disappointment of absolutely colossal proportions.
Quarterbacks get more than their fair share of haters.
Look at this here. What's Cutler doing?
But in the case of Chicago's Jay Cutler, well,
the guy is a jerk face. We know that.
Cutler's not real happy.
No, he's not.
Look at him.
Specifically when he's smacking his left tackle.
Not only a mouthful, a little shoulder bump there on the way by.
If when you push somebody like he did Webb, if I was Webb, I'd have dropped him right on the spot. Down.
I'm not a big fan. Not. I talked to a former football player who said, you won't win a Super Bowl with him.
But it's another quarterback whose lack of a ring helped land him on our top 10.
The number 7 player you love to hate, Tony Romo.
This list is skewed. Who did this list?
Did you say you was ranked 7th?
We gotta talk to the guy. Did you do this list?
Maybe number 1 or 2.
He should not be on that list, and if he is, he probably should be like 15.
I actually thought Tony Romo was an Italian guy, so I always liked him.
Not high enough. What has Romo accomplished?
I have no idea what Romo was doing there, quite honestly, Brad.
Tony Romo's done nothing to deserve to get on this list other than not winning a Super Bowl, but of course, that's all that matters to Cowboys fans.
This is a disappointment of absolutely colossal proportion.
Look, Tony Romo's a nice guy who puts up great numbers and keeps his team in contention. So where's all the hate coming from?
He's the quarterback of the Dallas Cowboys, so people are going to hate him. It's that simple.
The Cowboy quarterback in history Romo most calls to mind for me is Don Meredith, because he is so misunderstood.
You know, it's like Tony Romo cut a deal with the devil or something, right? Like damn Yankees, to go from small school, undrafted quarterback to face of America's team.
He's playing the most high-profile position in sports. It's either Yankee shortstop or Cowboys quarterback. And I don't think in the beginning he knew how to handle it. Immediately he starts trying to set up dates with Carrie Underwood, Jessica Simpson.
I mean, the cat's clearly out of the bag, and Tony's been very good about dodging questions, but here's Jessica wearing a Dallas Cowboys jersey with a pink number 9 on it.
Several weeks later, Romo took a break before the 2007 playoff game with the Giants.
Obviously, the moment for him was being caught on vacation in Mexico with his celebrity girlfriend, what, the week before one of the biggest games of his life. That stuff will turn fans off every time.
Fourth down, Romo looking, throwing into the end zone for Witten. It is intercepted at the post, and the playoff drought will continue.
The next season, Romo's laid-back personality landed him in hot water again.
Tony can't backspace the locker room incident in Philadelphia at the end of 2008, where they just got pounded in a do-or-die game. It was win or go home, 44-6.
And now the route is officially on.
And his comments in the locker room were to the effect of, if this is the worst thing that ever happens to me, I've had a really good life.
I mean, even I was offended that time. I'm like, oh, and you just wanted to reach out to him and go, you can't say that.
Watch out, little play, boy. Don't hurt yourself.
Ultimately, Romo's on this list because his worst moments came in his biggest games.
If you don't make the field goal, you lose the game and you're out of the playoffs.
I'm sick of Romo. Every time any of the chips are down, can never come through.
There's the snap, the spot. Romo can't get the spot down. Romo's going to run it in. He's hit. He's knocked down. He doesn't get there. Are you kidding me?
I know there are Cowboys fans who don't like Tony Romo because they're spoiled. That's right. I said it. You're spoiled.
It all goes back to the fact that he's on America's team, and he's not America's quarterback.
He's got to follow in the footsteps of Roger and Troy, and the only way to sufficiently do that is to win a Super Bowl.
The number 6 player you love to hate, Ray Lewis.
He's gone now, right? I mean, like, can we say that he's done?
60 minutes of glory! Get pissed off right now, and you get pure hell today!
I live in fear. I have cold sweats. I wake up at night screaming that Ray Lewis might return.
This is your entertainment. God put me here to give y'all entertainment.
The fact that he drew attention to himself with that stupid dance that he did before games, and then the fact that he ran his mouth from beginning to end.
You can't hurt this! I'm a machine, jerk!
Ray Lewis should be like one or two on the list.
With that whistle blow, we on this hell today.
The number 6 player you love to hate was an all-time great. Lewis was a 2-time Defensive Player of the Year and reached 13 Pro Bowls.
Ray Lewis caused the fumble and recovered the fumble.
But the beef with him isn't between the whistles.
I started hearing about all the good things he does for Baltimore.
I'm handing out turkeys right now.
And I like that. And then you see him in pregame. I hate that.
Somebody get him his meds already. It looks like he's having a full body spasm, and I'm worried, like, he's having a seizure, and that they have to shove a wall in his mouth because he's going to fish out on
it. I mean, people hate the dance, and people hate it.
He just tries to put the focus on himself. If we didn't have cameras, would he be kissing the turf? Nobody saw it, he wouldn't go through all that.
How do I follow that?
The dance is about Baltimore. It's about the stadium. It's about the fans.
Those Ravens players, they love it. Those Ravens fans, they love it.
The ticket prices for the Colts game, the last game that he played in Baltimore, were through the roof. It's like seeing, you know, Mick Jagger or Bono or the Stones. In Baltimore, it's loved. Everywhere else, it's hated. And in Baltimore, we're okay with that.
This is it! We run this! We're in this territory! So let's act like
Ray Lewis is one of those guys who's too fired up.
Breathe it in the air! Breathe it in the air! Lewis is one of the guys
who want! Well, you like have to tap him to be like, maybe you want to simmer down a little bit.
He has a purpose.
Turn it up!
Everybody needs one of those guys.
Yeah, let's go!
If you had a babysitter that was that passionate about babysitting, you would love that babysitter.
It's time to do what we do.
Uncle Ray, open that door.
We're in the crib, though. We're in the crib, though.
What's up, kids? Uncle Ray's here.
Let's be who we are today.
Are y'all ready for some fun times with your babysitter tonight?
Tonight is about each other.
We're gonna watch a movie.
Everybody watching tonight.
A Disney flick.
If you can't find anything tonight, you're in the wrong business.
You would love that babysitter.
Put the smiles on your faces. This is a 60-minute ball game.
You want a Ray Lewis. People hate him, but they love to hate him and hate because they love him.
Coming up.
They love me over here. They love me.
What's not to love about being beautiful?
Maybe how's my hair look? Pretty strong?
This is a man card violation.
Cut that hair!
How can you like a guy like that? That's a guy you love to hate.
I'm coming to look for you after the game.
We hate to stop now, but we'd love to give you a recap of our list so far.
Number 10, Warren Sapp, Born to be Bad.
If he wakes up and he is not hated by someone, he can't go on.
Number 9, Tim Tebow, and there's nothing he can do about it.
They hate Tim Tebow because we're doing this again on Tim Tebow.
Number 8, never mess with a boy named Sue.
There's just no place for that in football.
He's filthy. He's just a filthy, filthy player.
Number 7, the ladies love him, but he breaks cowboy hearts.
And the playoff drought will continue.
Number 6, intros in Baltimore become Groundhog Ray.
I mean, people hate the dance. People hate it.
And now, the number 5 player you love to hate, Tom Brady.
Is it hot in here? Tom Brady. I mean, are you sweating? And I feel like I'm a little bit flustered. Am I blushing? That's how I feel about Tom Brady.
But a woman in the wedding dress. Wow.
Listen here. You don't really hate Tom Brady. You want to be Tom Brady.
Why do the men hate Tom Brady?
Oh, here's this guy from California, super dashing.
The amazing ads that he's in. You know, he looks like a model.
Tom Brady could be selling insurance and still get a hot wife.
Yeah, oh yeah.
The guy puts in the work. The guy's extremely good at what he does.
Brady has been spectacular.
They win more games than anybody else.
He has 3 Super Bowl rings.
Guy wins MVP awards.
The guy's so good. He's the golden boy who makes a lot of money.
I think we're all jealous because his wife's pretty hot.
He procreated with one of the best-looking women on the planet, and they have awesome kids and an awesome life. And they have a moat, like a legit moat.
His life is charmed. His life is perfect. Maybe it's just that he has too much. The perfect situation, I think, for a lot of guys.
All those guys who are like working 9-to-5s and like busting their hump, like that's the guy, of course you'd hate Tom Brady.
Why are we hating Tom Brady? We should all be jealous of Tom Brady.
This is a guy that you can hate. You can get around this. I mean, you can sort of get on that hate bandwagon with Tom Brady.
I don't know that people really hate Tom Brady. I think it's more they don't like the Patriots. They've almost become to the level of the Cowboys, to the level of Notre Dame. You either love them or you hate them.
If you're not a Patriots fan, why would you like Tom Brady?
Yeah, I hate Brady.
Tom Brady, you are Tom Terrific.
He throws 6 million touchdowns, and they're all against your team. And it gets to the point that I think the Bills have beat Brady exactly twice.
Well, if you're a Jet fan, you gotta hate him, of course.
But Tom Brady said, give me the carving knife. I'm carving a turkey today.
And the fact that he plays for the evil empire up in Foxborough, I think that's part of it, too.
I think, Brady, you got to put on that list because people don't like the Patriots. People don't like Belichick.
With the face, with the way he acts, and the hoodie.
You know, he's the villain to so many teams. Look how many teams he's made miserable.
That guy bothers me. Give me a smile once in a while. Act like you like your players. Pat somebody on the butt.
Tom Brady, overrated.
Okay. So we're having a hard time pinning anything really nasty on Brady. He's got to have an Achilles heel somewhere.
Tom Brady has a spot that's approximately this big that you're allowed to tackle him on. I think you can get him on the one. If you get him to the two, lower or above, he's going to give the ref a look and then the flag's coming out.
Personal foul, roughing the passer.
That's what we call it in Buffalo. It's right, roughing the Brady. It's not roughing the passer. So, yeah, that's what you can get him for. Man, that guy hates being hit. He does.
The number four player you love to hate.
Four.
Hines Ward.
My kind of guy. Here's a guy that, hey, would knock you out. Definitely he deserves to be on that list.
I saw Hines on. I didn't know why they hate Hines. Because he takes cheap shots? All receivers take cheap shots.
Players hated Hines Ward.
What are they doing? Cheap shot?
When you talk to him privately, they hated Hines Ward. But if you play with him, you love him. If you play against him, you hate him. He's one of those guys.
Is this show players you love to hate or players that other players love to hate?
In a 2009 Sports Illustrated poll, the number four player you love to hate was voted the number one dirtiest player.
As a defender, you don't include wide receivers in your mental space that someone's going to come and knock your block off. And here comes Hines, and he's not going soft. Yeah, he was going cheap shot you. Absolutely.
When you walk past him at 6 foot tall, he didn't look that big. But he played. He was a monster.
You'd knock him down. He'd get back up. He'd smile at you. He'd come back on the next play and then knock you out.
And then when they blow their whistle, I unleash the dragon. I try to knock me somebody ass out. And smile after I do it.
He'll go in there and light up and crack block one of your favorite guys and stands up and he has that smile on his face.
It absolutely makes it worse. Oh, that smile. Oh, a villain smile. Just an absolute villain.
You just want to climb through the TV and you know, choke him.
Who knew a simple smile could elicit such hate?
I think he'd be number one with a bullet. What happened? Dancing with the Stars kind of dropped him down a little bit.
A lot of people say he danced dirty. He's one of the dirtiest athlete dancers. On, and maybe that's why people hate him.
Coming up, who's angry that they're not higher on this list?
What do we have to do to be number one on this list?
Come hate us. We're going to beat you.
They're only number three? Because I'm crack?
We've seen that the hottest attractions draw the harshest critics. But what if there are too many individual stars that wear the same uniform?
I'm thinking like a Dallas Cowboy. Because those guys, I couldn't stand.
You love them or you hate them. Roger Staubach was too good to be true. Troy Aikman, Emmitt Smith, they're too good to be true.
I don't think we should underestimate Michael Irvin's place in this world.
How about Neon Deion? I couldn't stand Neon Deion. He played great.
People just felt they were too perfect.
While plenty of Cowboys had haters, our number three had so many villains, we couldn't pick just one.
The number three players you love to hate. The Raiders.
The entire Raiders are number three?
You mean you picked an entire 53-man roster?
What year? Okay, I ring my bell on my show for genius. That's genius.
That's outrageous.
That's pretty good. You guys are doing your job.
I imagine the Raiders would be annoyed that they're only at number three.
They wanted to be disliked. The owner wanted to be disliked. The owner died wanting to be disliked.
I think that was the culture in the locker room. We're the Raiders. Come hate us. We're going to beat you. And they did.
You are magnificent out there today.
Over the decades, owner Al Davis created an image custom built for our top 10.
You know, somewhere in heaven, Al Davis is so happy that you guys put him on that list. That's where we love to be. They hate us because they want to be us.
And their identity is that they don't want to be you. And so by default, they're telling you that you stink.
We thrived off of that. We used to always say, it's us against the world.
And then you're like, well, then if you feel that way about you, then us, then I hate you.
You go into town, they boo you, and you could get excited. Then you really get motivated. So all the hatred was good.
Well, the Raiders are football immortality, all the way back to the Autumn Wind is a Raider.
The Autumn Wind is a Raider, pillaging just for fun. He'll knock you round and upside down and laugh when he's conquered and won.
They just were going to do the whole pillaging thing that Raiders are supposed to do.
It was almost like on Sundays, they let him come out from prison on a one-week furlough.
We said, lock up everything. Lock up the dogs, lock up the cats, lock up your girlfriends. Here we come.
I think the 70s Raiders teams are what put them over the top on this list because they played with a reckless abandon. They wanted to hurt you.
Holy Toledo, it's a free-for-all!
Ted Hendricks, the stork body slamming you.
Fred Biletnikoff, with his stick-em, the ball would stick to him no matter where it went.
Phil Villapiano, he had those arm pads with like steel in them. He was like a professional wrestler.
This was a team of villains in the NFL, but they played great, and that is a team you love to hate.
They carried it on from the players into the stands with the fans.
It's like a field trip to San Quentin.
You know, you have the whole goofball set that goes out there and turns the whole thing into Darth Vader every week in the black hole.
Welcome to hell.
The only number three? You guys on crack?
Actually, Bob, we're not. The Raiders slipped to number three because there hasn't been a lot to hate lately.
You can't hate the Raiders now. Al's dead. The team's terrible.
I think now, if you get the Raiders on your schedule, they probably love the Raiders because they stink.
It's almost pity hate, like because they like to be hated, right? So we're like, oh, you know, we'll hate you. What are you hating?
It's unfortunate that they're not more relevant because I think the Raiders are one of those handful of teams that you want to matter at the end of the day because it makes the NFL more fun.
Coming up next, the poster child for players you love to hate.
Oh, I think he's a lunatic. Cocky.
Selfish.
He is just an attention whore.
Least favorite player in the history of the league, maybe.
He wants people to hate him.
In the NFL,
I'm a diva.
No one generates more hate than a diva wide receiver.
Y'all talk about me?
Receivers like Chad Johnson,
Ocho Cinco from now on,
are not just annoying.
I'm not the bad guy. I love you.
Put the thing on me.
They are unavoidable.
I just inducted myself.
Make sure you keep the camera on me.
85 had haters.
You can always count on me. I'm like life insurance.
But nothing compared to this former teammate.
The number two player you love to hate. Terrell Owens.
Why do you hate T.O.? I mean, tell me why you hate T.O.
Oh, I think he's a lunatic.
Woo!
Cocky. Selfish.
I know you don't want me to sign, but I'm going to sign anyway.
20th century pop culture garbage fest.
You be cool.
The man is not a winner. He is just an attention whore.
Woo! I like it when they talk dirty to me.
It all overshadowed what he was as a player and how good he could have been and how many Super Bowls he might have won.
Hey, bro, you said they hate to like me, but that's all right. I'm going to get my ball on.
The only thing I don't agree with is how is T.O. not number one? I mean, he even says they love to hate me.
They still love to hate me!
He wants people to hate him. T.O. was savvy because he knew the NFL is about characters.
Ah!
You could be a villain.
They can hate me all y'all want to, but you can't stop me.
In the good old days, when he was young, he was humble, he was hardworking.
Young almost falls down, throws to the end zone. Owens! 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 He caught it! He caught it! He caught it!
He's a quiet young kid. He's crying after, you know, historic touchdown. Somehow along the line, you know, it turns, and it's all about T.O.
Is that a pin?
Yeah, he had a pin in his sock. And he pulled it out and autographed the ball.
I would say Terrell Owens is sort of a male version of Kim Kardashian.
Look, Mama, they got these cameras on me again.
He wanted everyone to look at him, and he wanted to get attention.
It's me!
Owens scored high on our list with his talent for getting under the skin of nearly everybody he opposed.
He completes it to Terrell Owens, breaks a tackle at the five.
Terrell Owens now doing the Ray Lewis dance. He reaches down, grabs some turf. He's doing Ray Lewis's dance in his face.
Standing on the star, I think everybody remembers that scene.
He's going to the star. He's going to the star.
You can't show your opponent up. You're just asking to get blistered, and blistered he did.
And George Teague levels him.
He's also near the top of our list because even his own teammates love to hate him.
That was a big problem. He had a lot of guys that didn't want to play with him.
One guy doesn't make a team. Break a team, maybe.
Warren Sapp's nickname is QB Killer. That might also be T.O.'s nickname. Because everywhere he goes, he just kills his quarterback.
I was open, Jeff.
Terrell Owens didn't like Jeff Garcia. Wanted to see the ball thrown downfield to him more.
I don't want to hear nothing. Just give me the ball.
He played angry. He was angry at me.
No, retire running. Yeah, rapper, nothing.
He was just angry at life.
His personality drove himself out of town.
You go back with the Eagles, he's with Donovan McNabb. They're setting records, they're playing great. Then he's got to ruin it.
And Donovan's just trying to get away from him and find some peace, but he will not let it rest.
He sabotages every relationship.
Terrell Owens has been suspended, conduct detrimental to the team.
It was like he jumped the shark when he was doing his hybrid driveway workout press conference.
I was asked to leave training camp today, and that's it.
Some would say this is starting to become a circus.
It is tough losing a guy of his caliber, but I think we might be better off.
Later in Dallas, when he complained to the media that Romo wasn't getting him the ball enough, the Cowboys cut him.
That's a guy like I shed tears for, I went to bat for, and then, you know, obviously he said, I'm not in Dallas anymore, and I know he definitely had a hand in that.
He was such a phenomenal talent, but yet so many teams who had him didn't want him anymore.
Come on, man, I know how to play football, man. Y'all tripping now.
You finally made the top of the list, the most hated.
Not so fast, Howard. Someone top T.O.
Wow.
But who?
I said that T.O. should be number one. You're right.
I thought so, too.
You guys absolutely got this right.
What are you doing?
Oh, I would think he's deserving of the number one spot.
Maybe. I don't know. How did that happen?
This is a list that everybody hates.
Oh, that's terrible. Terrible.
But before we unveil our number one player, here's our list so far.
Number 10, Warren Sapp, the mouth that roared. Number 9, Tim Tebow is a victim of his own popularity.
Nobody hates Tim Tebow. You hate the attention that Tim Tebow brings.
Look, people here.
Number 8, Ndamukong Suh needs a hot tub time machine.
Nobody would have said a word. He's playing in the 60s or 70s or maybe even 80s.
Number 7, Tony Romo. Welcome to the Blunderdome.
I'm sick of Romo. Every time any of the chips are down, can never come through.
Number 6, the masses sour on Sugar Ray.
They can't let them hide from me tonight.
He's gone now, right? I mean, like, can we say that he's done?
Number 5, Tom Brady.
Perfection personified.
What's not to hate?
Is it hot in here?
Number 4, a simple smile spawns hate for Hines Ward.
A villain smile. Just an absolute villain.
Number 3, the silver and black heart of the NFL.
They hate us because they want to be us.
Number 2,
they still love to hate me.
Yeah, we got that one right.
I'll give you number 1 in my book. Brett Favre, the most overrated quarterback in the history of the NFL.
You got it, Joe. And now, the number one player you love to hate, Brett Favre.
I can see why Terrell Owens would be, but Brett Favre, the gunslinger?
Oh, I would think he's deserving of the number one spot. I mean, enough with Favre. Didn't you guys already do an episode of the top 10 Favre moments?
Hey,
I said that T.O. should be number one. You're right. It's Brett Favre. You guys absolutely got this right.
That's right. Good call. Good call.
Why is that? Why do people hate Brett Favre?
Brett Favre is a hate mother.
He's named Ice Capades.
I think the reason people proclaim to hate Favre is because deep down they can't stand how much they really love the guy.
Please don't hate me. You love me?
I mean, you talk about a guy who is so ego-soaked and driven.
Dude, my head's getting bigger. These hats are getting smaller. Shut up.
Let's not forget all the brilliance that was his career early on.
The Vince Lombardi Trophy is coming home.
This is the best thing that's happened in Green Bay in a long time.
We oversaturated ourselves with Favre love. We had John Madden gushing over the Sandlot Kid style of play, and we ate it up.
That's why Brett Favre is Brett Favre.
Madden loved, he's got the slobber coming down and the mud's coming off his helmet.
But once you start hearing at home that he's the greatest thing ever.
He's the darndest guy I've ever seen.
It turns you against him.
This would make John Madden terribly sad.
He can pick up a baseball with his foot.
How could, in John Madden's world, Brett Favre be the worst anything?
Brett Favre throws as well as anyone. He throws better than anyone. What the heck am I talking about?
Stop it. Stop. Most overrated quarterback in the history of football. What great quarterback made as many dumb decisions in big games than Brett Favre? How about the one he threw? I think it was against the Eagles when he basically threw the ball underhanded and got intercepted.
Brian Dawkins interception.
Not to mention the one he threw in the championship game to Corey Webster against the Giants to cost him that one.
The pass intercepted by the Giants.
How about the one he threw in the championship game against New Orleans?
Intercepted. This is the cardinal sin for any quarterback.
And everybody loves him.
I loved Brett Favre.
Loves him.
I love the guy.
No, I loved Favre.
I mean, you gotta be kidding me.
For the number one player you love to hate, retirement speculation started in 2002.
I heard you were retiring on the paper this morning. You can give us a half anyways, man.
And continued for the next 9 seasons.
I'd like to make it a little easier.
This is called a fall from grace.
I promised I wouldn't get emotional.
I'm retiring.
I am officially retiring.
No, I'm not retiring.
Will he come back? Won't he come back?
I want the chicken. No, I want the shrimp. No, I want the chicken. You're just like, shut up already. That's Brett Favre.
Almost overnight, where he transitioned from the guy in Green Bay that everybody loved to the guy who just wouldn't go away.
And I don't think I got anything left to give.
Pedro Gomez or Sal Palantonio or one of those guys, I think, is still on Brett Favre's lawn.
Seems like just yesterday we were here.
Just in case he makes another comeback.
Well, I think we all know why I'm here.
He's going to be in a Gene commercial one day, and then he's going to announce his comeback, like, while playing touch football with some random B-list actors. That's going to happen, and America's going to be so sad.
Damn, Steven, what they got you in for?
I think if you were going to take a survey here of the 5 most popular players in my franchise history, he'd make it just based on his one season, 2009.
If Favre is so loved, where did all this hate come from?
You know, where does hate come from? It comes from love.
Players that you love to hate, you hate them because they're so good.
Jealousy's the biggest factor.
It's really about self-hate.
It was never about me. It was about everybody else.
You look at Favre, and you see he represents everything you don't have at the position.
He is cut from behind, got away.
And in a sense, it's the ultimate show of respect.
Holy cow!
You grow to hate somebody that beats you time and time and time again.
You suck, 50!
It's exaggerated emotions with the sports fan in America. If you love this guy, it's like he's the best since sliced bread.
Brady, you suck!
If you are an opponent of that guy, your hatred,
you suck!
Put him in a category that you just can't stand him.
He's the worst bet in the NFL.
We're a better country when we have an enemy. You know, when there was big bad Russia there, we were a prouder, better nation. And fans look at players the same way. You know, if you've got somebody who's just a surefire villain, it just unites that fan base.
Well, they might have kicked your team's butt. They might have played well year after year after year. Maybe they danced too much. Maybe they talked too much.
They hate to love me in here, baby.
Maybe they're media darlings.
Thank you, Tim.
The point is that I wish that guy was on our team, but he's not, so I hate him.